Before starting Linux Debian installation, we strongly advise to connect the computer to the internet as it will ease the installation and prevent further issues when installing some programs. We recommend using the graphical installation as it will allow a user-friendly installation. First, we select the language. This language will be used for the installation process and will be the default language of the operating system. We select our location. It will be used to set the time zone. We chose a keyboard configuration. It is important to make the right keyboard choice as it may cause issues when typing passwords later. Next step is network configuration. Here, the current system has multiple network interfaces, two network cards have been detected. The one selected by default is the interface that is already connected to the network. So, we will keep this one. At this step, if the installation wizard informs you that no network card was detected, it means that the current Debian distribution does not have a compatible driver. Internet connection would be then impossible. In this situation, we recommend continuing with the installation normally. After installing Linux Debian and Caldera RIP, it will be possible to download the missing driver from Workspace. Let's continue with the installation. If the company domain is unknown, you can leave this field empty. The hostname is a single name which identifies the current computer in the network. So, we make sure to use an identifiable name such as Caldera RIP. When setting up multiple RIP stations in the same local network, make sure to indicate it in the hostname. For instance, Caldera RIP 1, Caldera RIP 2, etc. It is time to set up users and a password. First, we must choose a root password. This password is the administrator password, and it will be asked each time system changes are made. We recommend using Caldera as the administrator password. Now, it is required to create a new user account. We recommend naming it Caldera. Then we enter a password for the Caldera account. We recommend it to type Caldera as the account password. Finally, we select a username for the new account. Once again, it is recommended to choose Caldera as the new username. Next steps are dedicated to disk partitioning. In other words, we will define where to install the new system. The most common and easiest choice is to use the entire disk. Then we select the disk where we want to install the system. There are currently two disks available, the internal hard drive and the USB flash drive we plugged in earlier. Of course, we make sure to install the system on the internal hard drive. We advise placing all files in one single partition. Separating /home is useful when there is a small SSD for the system and a larger HDD for the documents. Here is an overview of the current setup. We select Finish Partitioning and write changes to disk to validate. Finally, we click Yes to write changes to the disk. This action will destroy all existing data from the hard drive. The installation process should last around 5 minutes. Once the installation is completed, the Debian installer asks us if we want to use a network mirror. A network mirror is a repository where we can download additional Linux packages and updates later on. So, we recommend using a network mirror if a network connection is available while installing Linux Debian. We must select a repository from where we will be able to download additional resources. It is recommended to select your country or a nearby country to optimize downloads. Finally, we select a server. Usually, deb.debian.org is a smart choice. If a proxy is required to access the outside world, we would enter the proxy information here. Typically, such kind of information need to be entered on big corporate networks, otherwise this can be left blank. Okay, the installation is done, and it is time to boot into the new system. We make sure to remove the USB flash drive so that we boot into the new system rather than restarting the installation. After logging to the Caldera user account, here is how a fresh Debian looks like.